So the algorithm that allows us to identify high modularity score communities is called the Louvain algorithm from a university, Louvain in Belgium. That's why this name. So it is a very scalable and very popularly algorithm. Kind of, it's a de facto thing you would use if you want to partition the network into a set of clusters. So Louvain algorithm is a greedy community detection algorithm that scales n log n, where n is the number of nodes in the network, so it can scale to large networks. It supports weighted graphs, and it provides us hierarchical communities. So it doesn't only provide us clustering at one level, but it provides us kind of clustering of clusters. So we get this notion of a tree or a dendrogram, how individual nodes join into groups and how these groups can then be further joined into the supergroups, and so on. And as I said, it is very widely used. There are fast implementations available. It works very quickly and works well in practice. It finds clusters, communities that have a high modularity. The algorithm operates in two phases, where basically we want to greedily assign nodes to communities to maximize modularity. And each iteration, each pass, contains two phases. So in phase one, modularity is optimized by allowing only local changes of nodes to communities. So basically, nodes get a chance to change community memberships. And in phase two, these identified communities are aggregated into the supernodes to build a new supernode network, so that then another part of community detection can be run. So the idea is the following: the input network, we start with an input network, we optimize in phase one the modularity of it, so we find clusters, then we join these clusters into supernodes to create this aggregate network. Now we have a new network over which we can again run phase one to cluster it further. And this way we find clusters, clusters of clusters, and so on, and we hierarchically cluster the network. So now let me explain how phase one works. Phase one, we start by putting each node in the graph into a distinct community. So each node says, I am my own cluster, I am my own community. And each node I, for each node I, the algorithm performs two calculations. It computes the modularity when putting this I into a community with some other neighbor j. So basically, we take the node I and say, what if I put node I and put it into the community of node j? Would that increase modularity? And the idea is that I now, for a given node I try to put it into the same community as every single of its neighbors is already a member of. And whatever increases the modularity the most, that's where I put I, that's the community I put I into. And this phase one would kind of, we would iterate over the nodes until no movement is possible that increases modularity. So the first phase stops when the local maxima in modularity is obtained. Basically means no individual nodes can move to a different community to improve modularity. Note that the output of the algorithm depends on the order in which we consider the nodes. In practice, it turns out that the ordering is not important, so you fix some random ordering, and that's how you process nodes. And then for every node, you say, what if I join you with community with neighbor 1, neighbor 2, neighbor 3, see which of these joinings increases the modularity the most, and you move the node there. If none of the moves increases modularity, then you just don't move I to the community of node j. So what is elegant is that this modularity gain, right, this delta modularity, where you say, what if I take node I and move it from the current community D to the new community C, this can be computed very efficiently. And the way you can compute it is that you split it out into two terms. One term is, how will modularity change when I take node I and I take it out from the current community D? And then, how is the modularity going to change when I take this same node I and put it into the new community C? So the way you can think of picture is that, you know, I'm right now looking at node I. Let's say node I is assigned to some community D. I pick some of its neighbors. Maybe I pick this node here that belongs to the community C. So I say, what happens if I take I and kind of move it to the community C. So first is, I have to compute the delta modularity by taking I and moving it out of D, and then I need to compute the delta modularity for merging I back into the community C. And summing these two terms will give me the delta modularity, the increase or decrease in modularity when I move D when I move I from D to C. So let's derive this delta modularity when I move I into the community C. First, we need to derive the modularity of community C as it is. Let's call this Q of C. And the way we derive this is we need kind of two sufficient statistics. One is the sum sigma inside, which is the sum of the links, number of links or sum of the link weights between the members of C. And then sigma tot will be the total number of links that all these nodes have, right? So this is only inside the members, and this is inside plus outside, right? So here I'm only summing degrees, I'm only summing counting edges that are inside the members of the C, and when I compute the total, I also account for all the edges. So I just sum up the degrees without wherever the edges go. So now I have these two quantities, sigma in and sigma tot. So now I can rewrite modularity in terms of sigma in and sigma tot, right? So here is modularity of a given community C. It's this 1 over 2m we had before, double summation over all pairs of nodes in C, whether they are connected, minus the normalized product of their degrees. If I distribute the summation inside, I see here that this is basically now the number of edges between the members of the group. So this is sigma in divided by 2m, and what I have here is a summation of the degrees of the nodes in C, another summation of the degrees of nodes in C divided by 2m squared. So that is sigma tot divided by 2m squared, right? So this is, and this square here comes because I take this 2m and distribute it inside. So this means now that QC is large when most of the total links are within the community and very few cross to other communities. So now that we have defined, computed the modularity of C, now we need to say how does this modularity change when we take this node I and put it into C. And here we are going to use this notion of a case sub I, comma in, which is the number of edges that node I has to other members of C. And k sub I is now the total degree of node I, right? So basically these two terms are equivalent or analogous to sigma in and sigma tot, right? It's the total degree versus degree to or the number of edges to other members of C. And now if I write this out, right? So the modularity I had before was modularity of C that we have already defined, plus the modularity of this, let's say, isolated community I. So it has, I doesn't have an edge with itself, so it's 0 minus k sub I times k sub I with 2m, so it's k sub I squared. And now after I have moved in to the community C this node I, what do I get is the number of edges inside sigma in increases by k sub I in, and the total number of edges now increases, or total sum of the degrees now increases for the degree of node I. So this is how I can write it all together now. And then, right, here is, we said, delta modularity after I move I into community C is, you know, after minus before. This is after, right? I have the sum of the degrees inside the community is increased by this term. The total number of degrees is increased by the degree of node I. So this is the after modularity. This is the before modularity we have defined. And now if I simplify this, I basically, this is the expression, the expression I get. And what is nice, it depends on this sufficient statistic sigma in and sigma tot, as well as the degree of node I and the number of edges that I has to the nodes of community C. So this was the term that we have just derived is this one. And then we can analogously determine, derive a similar expression that says, how does modularity change when I take node I outside community D? Sum this up together and I get a delta modularity. So now that I know how to compute delta modularity quickly, I basically iterate between, for every node, I try to see, is there an opportunity to increase modularity if I move it to a different community? I compute this delta modularity and I move the node into some new community C prime based on the in a greedy way, based on how the overall modularity is increased. And this is essentially how the first phase of this Louvain algorithm will operate. So now, now that I have reached the local optima and I have moved nodes to different communities until the modularity stopped increasing, then I move to phase two, which is called restructuring, right? So now I want to take these clusters communities obtained in phase one, and I want to contract them into supernode create a new network, a next level network, where supernodes are connected if there is at least one edge between the nodes of the corresponding communities. And the weights of the edges between two supernodes is the sum of the edge weights across all edges between their corresponding communities. And now I will have a super graph, and I simply go and run phase one again. All right, so the idea is I have my original network, I run phase one to identify clusters, now I contract each cluster into a supernode, I connect two clusters if there is at least one edge between them, and now this will be a weighted network where the edge weights are denoted here, so this will be the total number of edges between C1 and C2, and this will be the total number of edges between the members of C2, and so on. And now that I have the super graph, I simply apply my phase one algorithm again. So the way this will work is, to summarize, I have my original network, I pick a node, and initially I put every node into its own community, and then I ask a node, what if I move you to the same community as your member node 2 is at? How would that change modularity? What if I move you to the community of node 3? How would modularity change? What if I move you to community of node 5? How would modularity change? So as I do these moves, I then decide to move it to wherever the modularity changes the most. And after the phase one finishes, this is the assignment of nodes to communities. Now I create this phase two, where I create a super graph, where I contract all the nodes of the same community into a super node, and then the edge, the self loop is the total number of, twice the number of edges inside. The cross edges are how many edges from one cluster point to another cluster. This gives me a super node network, and now I simply apply phase one again by clustering this. You know, here I would get the following two clusters. Again, I contract into super nodes. So here I have now basically the two communities. So what this means is that this original graph can be first split into two communities, the violet and green one, and then, you know, the green one can be super again split into two more communities, and the violet into two more communities, and then each of these four communities is denoted in this network. So we get this hierarchical structure. And just to give you an example, if you look, for example, at a Belgian mobile network, right? Belgium is a place where there are two people speak two languages. There is a strong French community and there is a strong Dutch speaking community. And if you look at the social network of phone calls, you see very nicely how the country splits into two separate parts, where, you know, French speak to French, Dutch speak to Dutch, and there's a relatively little connections between the two. So to summarize, we have defined the notion of modularity, which gives me the overall quality of the partitioning of a graph into communities. And then we talked about the Louvain algorithm for modularity maximization, where basically it is a greedy strategy where we start with every node belonging into its own cluster, and then we move nodes between clusters so that the overall modularity keeps increasing. After no moves are possible anymore, we join the clusters into supernodes and again repeat the clustering, and this way we get this kind of nice hierarchical community structure. Louvain works really well in practice, scales to large networks, and people really like to use it.